Hello again, it's me, Naraya. I'm back. And with Valentine's Day rapidly approaching, I'm gonna teach you how to turn this
into this.
If you still need a gift for a special person in your life, I wanna show you how to take a favorite pair of boots and turn it into a beloved handbag. Maybe you have a pair of boots laying around that you absolutely love, but are just totally worn out, no longer fit, or just aren't really your style anymore. I'd seen some people with handbags made out of the tops of boots, and I thought that was just ingenious. What better way to preserve a pair of boots that you love but can't wear anymore, or make just because it's super cute? So I did a little figuring and came up with a handbag that you can make yourself out of the tops of nearly any pair of cowboy boots. The great thing about this is it's not an exact science, and so you can really make it using whatever boots you have and with whatever materials you have at home. If you have an actual leather working kit, great, that's awesome. But if you don't let that deter you. I think you could totally pull this off. Here's some of the materials that you might need. For cutting, you're looking at needing either an X-Acto knife, perhaps an actual leather cutter, or maybe just a really sharp pair of shears that are heavy duty if you have them and have thin enough leather. Then when it comes to something that you'll need to stitch everything up with, if you have actual thread for leather work, that's great. Or if you have just thin strips of leather that can also work really well. Crafting twine that's strong but thin enough for use in a project, go ahead and use that. Paracord, really whatever you've got to stitch it together, whatever fits your style will work. Old boot laces, $3 tan beading from Walmart, even zip ties. Just kidding, don't use zip ties. Even I'm not that redneck.
Obviously, you're also going to need a pair of cowboy boots, and I used 4 non-welded metal rings to attach the straps of the purse. I also used magnetic clasps, which I'll explain later in the video. I've included links in the description to where you can buy all of these things on Amazon, but if you don't want to buy anything, you could always just make something out of fabric or leather or some other sort of tie out of whatever it is that you already have at home. You're also going to need some tools. I highly recommend having a leather hole puncher, but if you don't have that, that's okay. Get some other sort of device that can bore a hole into the leather. I also used a mallet, leather stitching equipment, and these pair of pliers. The first step is to go ahead and cut the top of the boot off from the bottom of the boot. I recommend cutting as close to the bottom as you can to give yourself some extra playing room. So you just take whatever cutting device you have and cut all the way around the base of the boot. This is honestly probably the hardest part of the whole process. So if you're struggling on this part, don't give up, it gets easier. Once your boot has been completely detached, you can see the front of the boot is going to be the middle of your purse. So turn it around until you're looking at the back stitch of your boot. You are going to separate the boot at this point. You can either go through and tear and remove the stitches that are already there, but that's more time consuming. Personally, I would recommend just going and cutting along that seam. Once the seam is cut, you can open up the boot and see one side. You'll notice mine has a lining on the inside, and now you're going to repeat this process with the second boot. I'm going to shape it to kind of the desired shape of the purse. I'm rounding off the edges so that the handbag has kind of a smooth curved look instead of a box-like shape. Make sure then, once you have your second piece cut, that you go along and follow whatever pattern you cut for the first piece, follow and cut that same pattern for the second boot, making sure that they remain lined up so that they're both equal and the same size. You may notice where the very front of the boot was is kind of a little bit of a bulge. And so in order to get rid of this extra space that's being taken up by the leather, you're going to want to flip over the boot, pinch up the bulge until it's meeting flush with itself, and then you're going to mark a line where you would want that to meet. We'll sew a thin line of stitching across this area to hold it together. That way the outside of your purse is completely smooth. To do that, I'm going to use the leather tool to bore holes into the leather that I can then stitch through. But again, if you don't have this kind of tool, you could always use a small drill bit, and you could actually just drill holes evenly spaced out into the leather and then sew the stitching or whatever you have through there. It's just important that whatever size stitching you use, you're using that size drill bit or hole punch. I'm using actual leather work stitching for this area, but however it works out for you, this is not a make it or break it part of the purse. And once I have that whole side sewn, I will tie a little knot and call it good. Here I'm attaching the bottom piece of the magnetic clasp that's going to keep the purse strapped together, kind of holding it shut. So to do this, I'm going to hold one of the pieces where I want it, mark that spot with a small incision, and then go through and cut two small little incisions that I can then poke the prongs of the metal piece through. It will then have a washer that goes on the back, and all I have to do is just fold the pieces down, kind of like you might do on a manila envelope when you're about to send something in the mail. That's all there is to that, and since I have that covering, it'll stay hidden and it won't be seen from the inside. Now comes the important part, actually making the stitching for the side. The first step to do is measure where we want the holes that the stitching will go through to be. Because this leather is thick, you can't just poke a needle through it as if you were sewing something. I'm making my spaces fairly far apart, but you can put yours closer together if you want a tighter stitch. The larger the object they're using to attach your purse, so like paracord or a thick piece of leather, the bigger the hole needs to be. Again, using either a leather punch or a drill bit and just drilling it evenly spaced apart. If you're using something thinner and finer, then you can make smaller holes and put them closer together. And again, you're just going to continue this process all the way around the edge, evenly spaced out. Once you have your holes punched, you can make a decision about how you are going to stitch your purse. You can either stitch it with the insides touching each other and the outsides both facing outside, and do kind of a crisscross stitch across the outside of it. If you do this, I would recommend doing an X pattern stitch, and this will allow you to see the stitch really clearly from the outside. This is what I would recommend if you have a really thick type of leather. But since my leather is thin and has this inside lining, I'm actually going to do a hidden stitch. So I'm going to flip both of my pieces inside out so that the good side is facing the inside. Then I'll go ahead and I'll stitch around this way so that when I flip it inside out, the stitch will be hidden for the most part. I decided to use the thinner tan cord for mine since I was doing it on the inside. If I were doing a stitch on the outside, I would probably have used either a dark brown or black material just to give it some contrast and really make it stand out. But since this is not the focal point of my purse, I'm using a neutral color. And again, I'm just going to stick it through those holes that have already been pre-punched or pre-drilled, and I'm just doing a very simple in and out pattern since these aren't decorative or made to be seen. Again, like I said, if I was doing it on the outside, I would probably do like a twisting pattern or maybe an X or something a little more decorative. But for now, this just looping through is going to give me enough strength and hold the purse together and do what it needs. It's just going to do what I need it to do. And so I'm going to just keep the same motion all the way around the entire edge of the purse. When I get to the end, I'll loop it back through itself and make sure I tie a knot super tight to keep all of that in place. Before I tie that knot, though, I did check to make sure my tension was good all the way throughout the whole bottom of the purse. Now it's ready to be flipped back, right side right. So I just go ahead and pull it all the way through. Once I have this done, you can see how it looks from the outside. You can see a little bit of the stitching, especially at the bottom. If you wanted to see less of that, you'd just have to stitch it closer together and much, much tighter than I did. However, since mine has the lining on the inside, I didn't mind having the stitches showing because nothing is going to fall through this purse since mine has the lining on the inside. But if you didn't have that lining on the inside, then I would maybe recommend doing a closer together stitch so that you don't have any gaps in the bottom of your handbag. The next part to do is attaching the rings to the top of the boot straps. Most cowboy boots already come with these little straps there. So I'm just taking these non-welded metal rings. So you can see they have a small gap in them, but they're too thick of metal for me to pull apart with my hands. So I actually have to stick the pliers in there and then pull them apart, creating a small gap in the ring. It requires two people to actually get the ring onto the top boot strap. One person to open the pliers, creating leverage, and the other person to wiggle the leather through that small opening onto the boot. There might have been a small gap created while you were stretching it, so you can just kind of squeeze the outside with the pliers again, and you just repeat the step with all four of the rings. Now you have to decide what you're going to use for straps. I have some extra leather, so I'm going to use that because I think it accents the purse really well. But again, you can really use whatever you have, cloth, rope, an old belt, etc. Just decide what you want to be the outside and what you want to be the inside. You're then going to wrap it around the rings that you've put on the purse. I'm, again, sewing mine on using a hole punch and string. You can see there that I made sure it went all the way through before I start sewing it on. But again, if you have something else that you either tie on or loop on or hook on or attach in some other way, there are multiple different options for how you could attach the straps to your purse. The last piece that I'm going to add is a strap to help keep the purse closed, kind of a latch that it's going to go on there. I've already cut out the piece of leather that I'm going to use for it, and so I punch holes around the back, and I sew the back piece on using the same method that I used for the purse straps. I'm sewing a really strong stitch here because I want this to withhold any weight or pull put on it. So you can see here, I've just got that V-shaped strap. This, again, is the back side of the purse. The top flap will fold over to the front, where then it will connect to the magnetic piece that we already attached to the front. So all that's left is to add that magnetic piece on. I make sure to line it up with exactly where on the leather flap I want it to be. I mark that place and then go ahead and cut again, two small slits for each of the prongs of that magnetic piece to go through. I just cut that out with my knife, and then I go ahead and push the metal clasp through. You add on the washer and fold those pieces down just like a manila envelope. And there you have it. At this point, the purse is basically done. The only thing that's left to do is add a little bit of style. Right now you can see the top part of the magnetic clasp, and that's kind of tacky. So here's where you can add something decorative on top of it to cover it up. You have tons of options here. You could use a cool looking stone, a shell, some other piece of leather work, a pin that you really like, maybe even an FFA award pin, a piece of fancy glass, a rock, a concho that you might have from something else. And what I've decided on, since Valentine's Day is approaching, I'm going to go with this heart-shaped concho. To attach it, I'm first going to sew a small piece of leather right above where I put that metal clasp. So I'll have to punch a couple of holes, and then I sew it on there. Once that has been secured in place, I simply have to slide the leather straps through the concho to put the concho exactly where I want it in place. And there you have it. The purse is done and completely put together. And that's all there is to it. Again, lots of ways that you could style it, make it your own. I really like having the strap, but you could leave it off if you didn't want it. You could add a lining, you could not do the lining, do all different things with the strap, but that's the basic shape of the boot purse.
Well, I'm super glad that we did this project today. I really like the way that it came out. It definitely was a struggle at some points figuring out what I was gonna do with the straps, what I was gonna do with the stitching, how to do all the size proportions, but all in all, I love it. It is the perfect size for two books, and if you know me, you know that I love to read. So the fact that I can just super nifty fit those in there is a win to me. And again, depending on what cowboy boots, straps, etc. you use, these could turn out super different, which is what I think is really beautiful about them and makes them very, very unique. I hope this inspired you to maybe try something at home, make a new use for a pair of your older boots. It's always a really exciting time when you don't have to throw something out, when you can reuse or recycle. And so if you have any ideas that you've seen, you've done personally, or that you really want to try, or maybe that you would love me to try and figure out for you, about ways to reuse any sort of Western gear, leave those in the comments. As always, use this space to connect with others, work diligently, act justly, and always be courteous to everyone.